तो आपने देखा इन फर्स्ट वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द एसेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन. लेट अस स्टार्ट द डिस्कशन विद सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन. सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन इन्वॉल्व द टू पेरेंट्स, सो वी कैन से दैट इट इज बाई पेरेंटल. द गैमेट फॉर्मेशन टेक्स प्लेस इन दिस टाइप ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन. सिंस द गैमेट फॉर्म्स, द फ्यूजन ऑल्सो टेक्स प्लेस एंड दिस फ्यूजन इज कॉल्ड फर्टिलाइजेशन. इन सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन अर्ली आई हैव टोल्ड यू दैट वेरिएशन अराइजेज एंड दीज वेरिएशंस आर बेनिफिशियल फॉर द इंडिविजुअल्स. सो इफ वी वॉन्ट टू डिफाइन द सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन, वी कैन से दैट अ टाइप ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन इन विच द टू पेरेंट्स आर इन्वॉल्व, गैमेट्स आर फॉर्म्ड एंड द फर्टिलाइजेशन टेक्स प्लेस. Now come to the stages of life. Each and every living individual have three stages in their life. The first is called juvenile stage, the second is called reproductive stage, and the third is called senescent phase. So stages of life can be divided into three parts. The juvenile phase, next is the reproductive phase, and the senescent phase. So the life of animals can have three stages. इन जनरल हम लोग बात करते हैं कि किसी की भी जिंदगी में तीन स्टेजेज होती हैं, बाल्यावस्था, युवावस्था और वृद्धावस्था. द सेम इज डिस्कस्ड हेयर, द जुबेनाइल फेज, द ग्रोथ फेज, द मैच्योरिटी फेज मींस द बॉडी सेक्स ऑर्गन्स स्टार्ट फंक्शनिंग, दिस इज कॉल्ड मैच्योरिटी फेज. एंड द सेनेसेंट फेज when the reproductive part becomes non-functional but the person is still living, so this is called senescent phase. In general hum log budhapa bolte hain isko, theek hai. To teeno phases ke bare mein aapko bataya gaya. Plant mein agar hum isi cheez ko consider kare to plant mein bhi aap dekhiye, plant jab grow karaya jata hai, so the first phase is juvenile phase that can be called as vegetative phase in case of the plant. Vegetative phase means, पहले भी मैं डिस्कस कर चुका आपसे, जहां पर रूट, स्टेम और लीव्स डेवलप होंगे प्लांट में. सो द वेजिटेटिव फेज इज द ग्रोथ फेज इन विच द प्लांट डेवलप्स दियर रूट, स्टेम एंड लीव्स. आफ्टर दैट द फ्लावर कम्स इन प्लांट and this is the indication of maturity of a plant, because flower is the reproductive part, so we can say that the plant get matured and their sexual organs start functioning. The flower contains these sexual organs which are called male reproductive part and the female reproductive part. When the sexual parts start non-functioning or becomes non-functional, the last life of the phase, the last phase of the life is start, and this is called senescent phase. So in sexual reproduction, the sex organs produces the gametes. Since it is biparental, the male part present in the male body and the female part present in the female body. In this way there is method or the different methods which are applied by the different organism. So what are the stages of sexual reproduction? The different events which are takes place before the fertilization, they are called pre-fertilization events, and all the events which are takes place after fertilization, they are called post-fertilization events. Now what the steps which are completed in the pre-fertilization event are called pre-fertilization event, and it includes the gamete formation and transfer of gamete. Gamete formation is also called gametogenesis. तो कह सकते हैं कि फर्टिलाइजेशन से पहले होने वाली सारी घटनाओं को हम प्री फर्टिलाइजेशन इवेंट बोलेंगे और फर्टिलाइजेशन के बाद होने वाली सारी घटनाओं को पोस्ट फर्टिलाइजेशन इवेंट कहा जाएगा। प्री फर्टिलाइजेशन इवेंट में दो पार्ट हैं, एक आपका फॉर्मेशन ऑफ गैमेट या गैमेटोजेनेसिस और दूसरा है आपका ट्रांसफर ऑफ गैमेट। How the gamete transfer from the male body to the female body. So let us start with the gametogenesis. We can simply define the gametogenesis as the process of formation of gametes from gamete mother cell is called gametogenesis. Now there are two types of individuals, some are haploid while the other are diploid. So make sure the concept of haploid and diploid. Organism that cells have chromosomes without pair or single chromosomes, means the all the chromosomes present in a separate form, they are called haploid, while the other that have paired chromosomes, they are called diploid. So haploid and diploid. In haploid organism, the gametes are produced through the mitotic division. Mitosis takes place during the gamete formation, because gametes are haploid and the if the parent body is already haploid, then there is no need of deduction of chromosomes. Hence mitotic division takes place. While in diploid organism, the mother cell have diploid chromosome number and the gamete have haploid number of chromosome. The diploid chromosome must be reduced into haploid. Hence, meiosis takes place. तो डिप्लॉयड ऑर्गेनिज्म में द मदर सेल हैविंग द पेयर्ड नंबर ऑफ क्रोमोसोम दैट मस्ट बी रिड्यूस्ड इनटू द हैप्लॉयड. सो हियर यू सी द मियोसाइट और द मदर सेल मस्ट अंडरगोज मियोसिस एंड प्रोड्यूसेस द हैप्लॉयड क्रोमोसोम्स और हैप्लॉयड गैमेट्स. In lower organism, the cell division is also the method of reproduction. As I have already explained you that binary fission, during binary fission, the cell splits into two daughter cells. So the cell division can be considered as method of reproduction in unisexual organism. Now, the next step of the sexual reproduction is transfer of gamete. Before explaining this, there is one table in your NCERT book where the number of chromosome in meiosite and the number of chromosome in gametes are given over here. So you can fill it easily, because the number of chromosome in gamete are always haploid. Hence, suppose onion. If onion has 24 chromosome, that means diploid. So the haploid number of chromosome can be half of this. Okay. Likewise, you can fill all the table. One side there is meiosite number, means chromosome number in meiosite, while in other side number of chromosomes in gametes. So remember that the chromosome number is always double in meiosite and half in gametes. Now come to the transfer of gametes. When the gametes are produced by the individual, they must be transferred from male body to the female body. While this is the case of plant or animal. So before we have discussed the transfer of gametes in lower plants. In algae, everybody know that all the algae generally grow in water. So water is medium for transfer of gamete. In case of algae, fungi, mosses, fern, all the lower plants use the water for the transfer of their gametes. In case of mosses, the male gametes are called anthrozoites, and the male gamete of animals are called sperm, while the female gamete is called ovum or egg. So all the lower plant take water as a medium for transfer of their gametes. Now what about the gymnosperm and angiosperm? In higher plants, the medium of transfer of gamete may be changed, like the air or sometime water. So in gymnosperm, the air is generally used for the transfer of male gamete, means the pollen grains. And similarly in the angiosperm, means flowering plants. If we discuss about the higher animals, they have special organs for transfer of male gametes into the body of female, which is called copulatory organ. With the help of copulatory organ, the male transfers its male gametes into the body of female during the reproduction. So in pre-fertilization events, there are two important headings. One is called gametogenesis, formation of gamete, and other is called transfer of gametes. Now come to the fertilization. Fertilization is the most important event in sexual reproduction. When the gametes are transferred into the female body or to the female gamete, they get fused, and this process is called fertilization. So we can easily define the fertilization, the fusion of gametes. One more thing is that syngamy. The exact fusion of male and female gamete is called syngamy. Then how the fertilization differs from syngamy? So you can make the difference between the fertilization and the syngamy. The exact fusion of male and female gamete is called syngamy, while all the preparatory phase process for the fertilization is considered as fertilization. Types of fertilization. But in your NCRT, there is a question, where does syngamy occurs? Aapki NCRT mein question diya hua hai, syngamy kahan hoti hai? Usi ko maine aapko yahan bataya, types of fertilization, jo ki do tarah ka hoga. There are two types, external fertilization and internal fertilization. To uska answer ho jayega aapka, there are two types of fertilization, external fertilization and internal fertilization. Now understand the mean of these two. External fertilization means the fertilization that takes place outside the body of female. Okay? Outside the female body. Now, what are the more differences? In case of external fertilization, more and more gametes must be produced because many of the gametes are destroyed during the journey. So the losses of gametes is more in case of external fertilization, while the loss of gametes is little in case of internal fertilization. So this is the difference between the two types of fertilization. More risk, less risk to destroy the developing embryos also. So in different organisms, like most of the animals, yeah, animal groups, internal fertilization takes place. Some fishes and the group of amphibians apply the external fertilization. Otherwise, maximum of individuals, the maximum of the group of animals apply the internal fertilization. If we are discussing about the gametes, so in higher organism you see that the female gamete is always stationary while the male gamete is motile. It is transferred from the parent body, the male body, and travel a long distance or reaches to the female body. This type of fertilization, this type of reproduction is called oogamous type of reproduction. So after fertilization, the result is zygote formation. By the fusion of male and female gamete, whether it's the external fertilization or internal fertilization, the result is same. The zygote is produced, which is the first cell that link the parental generation to the coming generation, and this is the first cell that develops the new individual. So zygote is the most important cell that link the two generations, means the parental generation and the young ones. When the zygote undergoes the division, cell division and differentiation, it develops into embryo. Suppose the zygote is a single cell, and we consider the example of human being. The single cell first divides into 2, 4, 8, 16, likewise, and produces the 32 celled stage that get implanted into the uterus of the female body, that grows into the embryo. the growth of embryo or the different growth stages of the embryo is called embryogenesis. Is the next heading in your NCERT after zygote, embryogenesis. The development of embryos is called embryogenesis. So the cell that divides are differentiated and take their charge, are differentiated and take their functions separately to produce the new individual. In embryogenesis, most of the diploid organisms, the cells divide through the mitotic division. No need of reduction division. The same cells divide through the mitosis and containing the same number of chromosomes. Now come to the next heading, sexuality in organism. Sexuality in organism means you see that in some animals and in some plants, both the reproductive organs are present in the same body. While if we consider ourselves, means human being, the males and the females both are separated. So sexuality means which type of reproductive organ present in the same body or in a different body. In this way, there are two types of individuals. One are called monoecious, while the other are called dioecious. Monoecious and dioecious are the terms which are used especially for the plants, where we see that in case of monoecious, mono means single, body is single, containing both type of reproductive organs. Now define it. The single body contain both reproductive organs. Got it? The single body containing both reproductive organs. This condition is called monoecious. There is one diagram in your NCERT, CARA. In this diagram you see that this is, here you see the male and female, both are present in the same thallus. This is thallus. The male part and the female part, both part are present in the same body. If both the reproductive organ or both the part of reproduction are present in the same body, we can say it as monoecious. More examples are, cucurbits and coconuts. Here you see that the same plant contain both type of flowers, male part, yeah, male flower and female flower. Okay, now there is two term, pistillate and staminate. If any flower have only pistil, means the female part, then such flowers are called pistillate flower, while if the flower have only stamens, then we can say that it is staminate. So here you see that in cucurbit, the same plant have both type of flower, so it is called monoecious. So we have right here the three examples, cucurbit, coconut and cara. In all cases, the same body have both reproductive organs. Can you consider some more example? If we take an example of earthworm, in case of earthworm, you see that earthworm have both reproductive organs in same body, male and female. In case of hydra, you can see both the reproductive organs are present in same, in some species of hydra. Now, come to the dioecious condition. You see in your NCRT diagrams, the cockroach, the Merkantia, and the human being. Di means two. Di means two means two body having the single reproductive part. The male body contain male reproductive part and the female body contain female reproductive part. So we can easily define it, dioecious. The condition in which the single body contain the single reproductive part. Okay? Example, human being. In NCRT there is cockroach. And the third example is given here in your book is Merkantia. So, animal, in case of animal, if the single body have both reproductive organ, we use the term hermaphrodite. Hermaphrodite. Like in case of earthworm, where both reproductive organs are present in same body, we use the term hermaphrodite. And in case of plant, we use the term bisexual. So this is all about the sexuality in organism. Now, come to the events the changes that takes place in any organism, any flower after the fertilization. And before going to this one, there are small topics like, okay. So changes after fertilization in a flower. फर्टिलाइजेशन होने के बाद किसी भी फ्लावर में क्या क्या चेंजेज आते हैं उसके बारे में बताया जा रहा है आपको, ठीक है. आफ्टर फर्टिलाइजेशन द सेपल्स पेटल्स ऑल बिकम्स ड्राई एंड शेड ऑफ. द ओव्यूल चेंजेज इनटू सीड. जायगोट डेवलप्स इनटू एम्ब्रियो. And better say that the ovary change into fruit. So you can write here ovary changes into fruit wall. Here you see the diagram in your NCRT that there are some transverse section of different fruits where the seed and the pericarp is mentioned. So sometimes the CBSE can ask the function of these two parts, P and S. P is protective because it is pericarp, and seed is germinative because it is used for grow to new plants. So P and S, pericarp and seed. This is all about the chapter of this reproduction in plant. Thank you.